Welcome to DrBTrust.com. I'm Dr. Hemant Kumar. Cholesterol is a waxy substance which plays vital role in our body. So it is a key ingredient of the cell membrane. As you know, our body is made up of cells, and cell is the fundamental unit or building block of the body. So the outer bounding box is known as the cell membrane, which maintains the structural integrity of the cell. So cholesterol is a key part of the cell membrane. Cholesterol is also the precursor for synthesis of vitamin D and several other important hormones. Cholesterol is also a precursor of formation of bile salts in the body, which is important for the digestion. So as you can understand, that while you may have heard of cholesterol generally in bad terms, that it causes heart disease and all, but it performs some vital functions in our body. Total cholesterol. Total cholesterol is the combination of all the types of cholesterol in our body. Now, cholesterol is a waxy substance. Fat is not soluble in blood because blood is principally water. So, body creates a ball-like structure known as lipoproteins. It packs the fats, cholesterol and triglycerides inside in a core, and packs it with proteins, and these balls are known as lipoproteins. Think of something like a soft core candy which has a liquid gooey center and a sort of thickish crust outside. Something like that is the lipoprotein. So total cholesterol measures the cholesterol present in all the different types of lipoproteins in our body. What are the levels or what are the reference ranges for cholesterol? Less than 200 milligrams per deciliter of blood is taken to be an acceptable level for total cholesterol in our body. Levels between 200 and 239 milligrams per deciliter are taken to be borderline high levels. Readings above 240 milligrams per deciliter, so 240 milligrams or above per deciliter of blood, are taken to be high levels of cholesterol. Now, as we just discussed in the opening, high levels of cholesterol are associated with increased risk of heart disease and cerebrovascular disease, that is, the increased chances or risk of stroke. Because cholesterol, excess cholesterol, gets deposited on the inside of the arteries supplying these organs, creates blockages, leads to reduced blood flow, and sometimes complete occlusion of blood flow to these organs, and causes heart disease and diseases related to the brain. And that is why keeping cholesterol low, keeping cholesterol within manageable levels, is very important. And that is why you would have heard of cholesterol, heard about cholesterol and management of cholesterol in newspapers, in TV, everywhere. What is it that you can do to reduce cholesterol? Well, three things help in general management of lipids, including cholesterol. A, reduce weight. So if you do aerobic exercise for 30 minutes a day, brisk walking, swimming, dancing, yoga, that is considered beneficial to reduce your cholesterol levels. If you eat food which is less in saturated fats, trans fats, and generally low in fats, that is considered beneficial to improve your cholesterol levels. So getting to the desired weight for your body size, getting to the desired calorie levels for your level of activity, and eating healthy, more plant-based diet, high in fresh fruits, less in saturated fats, and generally less in fats, is beneficial in bringing down the cholesterol levels towards desired ranges. Hope you found this video useful. For more such videos, please log on to DrBTrust.com. Thanks for watching.